Hey guys, welcome back to our channel Logic to Code. So in this video I'll be talking about a problem called a strange number taken from CodeChef Long Challenge April 2020. So I have rewritten the problem statement, keeping all the essential details of the problem. You may also look at the original problem statement. The link of the original problem statement is given in the description. So let me read this short form of the problem. So you have given two integers x and k, and you need to determine whether there is an integer a such that it has exactly x positive integer divisors, and out of which k of them are prime numbers. So these are the constraints. So test case go up to 10 to the power 3, and x and k can go up to 10 to the power 9, right? So this is the sample test case given. So the number of test case is 1, x is 4, and k is 2. So answer for this test case is 1, which means yes, there is a number exists having total positive divisors 4, and out of which there are two prime divisors. So and the number having these xk combination is 6, so it has 4 factors, and the factors are 1 2 3 6, and out of these 4 factors the 2 factors are prime, which is 2 and 3. So now let me talk about the total number of factors. So if you have a number a, so for finding a total number of factors we just do a prime factorization of that number. So where a, b, c up to z are the prime numbers, and x1, x2, x3 and xn are their respective exponent. So then the total number of divisors would be x1 plus 1 into x2 plus 1 up till xn plus 1, right? So let's say we have a number a and we prime factorize this number like this. So according to the question, this would be the total number of positive prime divisors. So in this question we have given this information that x1 plus 1 into x2 plus 1 up till xn plus 1 equals to x. So x is the total number of positive divisors. So as you can see here is that x is written as a multiplication of n numbers, right? Because there are n terms, so x is written as multiplication of these n terms, right? So x can be written as like this, so which essentially means that there are n factors of x, and the factors are x1 plus 1, x2 plus 1 till xn plus 1, right? These are the factors of this number x. So now my claim is that if the number of factors of x is greater than k, then we can make a number a with the given xk combination. So what I mean to say is that if the number x has at least k prime factors, then we have a number a with the given xk combination. So why I'm saying is that, let's say we are having total x as total number of positive divisors, right? So now let's say x has k prime factors. So x can be written as x1 into x2 into xk, right? So x can have total k prime factors. So we'll break these k prime factors like this. So now given this x, we can make a number a like this: 2 to the power x1 minus 1, 3 to the power x2 minus 1, and so on and so forth. There will be total k terms in this, where the next term would be the next prime numbers. So now given this number a, so how you are going to find the total number of prime factor of this number? So what we'll do is that this number is written as its prime factorization. So we'll take exponent of all the prime numbers and add 1 and then multiply, right? So this is the total number of prime factors, right? So in some sense we are going just backward from here. So given k factors of x, we are finding a number a such that this number a has total k factors, right? So these 2, 3, 5, 7 are the prime numbers, right? So one thing that you could notice here is that for a given xk, we can get multiple a, right? So if I choose a different set of k prime numbers, then we'll get a different number, right? Here I am choosing 2, 3, 5, 7 k combination of prime numbers. You may choose some other k combination of prime numbers. Depending upon that, we'll get a different a, right? So now let's say if x has less than k factors, right? So my claim was that if x has at least k factors, then we can make a number a with given x k combination. Now let's say if I have less than k factor, so if you look at here, there will be less than k terms, right? So in the prime factorization, we have less than k prime numbers, right? Like, so let's say k equals to 3, then we have 2, 3 only, right? So 2 to the power something, 3 to the power something. So in that case, we only have two prime factors in this, in the prime in the total divisors of number a. So this would be very clear when we take the real examples. So then we can not have k prime factors out of the total x factors. So if x has less than k factors, so then we don't have k prime factors out of the total x factors, right? So now let's see with the some real examples. So let's say we have x equals to 12, right? So now I x prime factorize x, so x will be 2, 2 and 3, right? So it has 3 factors. So now with the 3 factors, we can make a like this, 2 to the power 1 into 3 to the power 1 into 5 to the power 2, right? So with given this a, the total number of factors will be this, like this, right? So in a reverse way. So there are total 12 factors and these are the 12 factors. Now let's look at one thing carefully over here. So there are total 12 factors, right? And there are 3 factors of x. That's why we have 3 terms over here, 2, 3, 5. And once you look at the total number of factors of this number a, there would be only 3 prime numbers. And the prime numbers would be 2, 3, 5, right? So let's look at 2, 3, 5. There is no other prime numbers except 2, 3, 5, because these are the prime factors. Once you multiply something to this, that cannot be a prime factor, right? So that's the concept come from, like, if it doesn't have k factors, then we don't have k terms in this, which means we don't have k prime numbers in the factorization, right? And ultimately we don't have k prime factors in the total of x factors, right? So let's see some real example. So let's say n equals to 15 and k equals to 2, right? So what I'll do is that I'll prime factorize n. So there are 2 terms, 3 and 5, right? So there are at least k factors, so at least 2 factor of n, which means that we have a with this given n k combination. And what is that a? So 2 to the power 2 into 3 to the power 4, right? So this number will be having total 15 factors, out of which 2 will be prime. And what are those 2 prime factors? 3 and 5, right? So, and one thing that I already told about that is there would be multiple a depending upon the 2 prime numbers that you are going to choose over here. So I choose 2 and 3, you may choose 3 and 5 and maybe other 2 combinations. So now let's say if we are given n equals to 15, k equals to 2. Now let's say n equals to 15x, where x can be any integer, k equals to 2, right? So in this case, the answer is going to be always true. Why? Because 15 has 2 prime factors, right? Once we multiply 15 with something x, then we are also going to get at least 2 factors of n, right? So let's say, for example, n equals to 30. So we are having 2 factors, right? Or even more than 2 factors, but we are not bothering about that. If we have at least 2 factors, we can make a number a, and the number a would be many numbers, right? So depending upon the prime number you choose, depending upon the factorization you do, let's say 30, I can factorize into 10, 3, 2 into 15. So depending upon the factors you have and depending upon the prime numbers you are choosing, you can get a different a, right? So in this case, the one possible a could be 2 to the power 1 into 3 to the power 14, right? So in this case, that if the number is 15x, k equals to 2, we are always going to get a, right? So now let's say see a different example. So let's say n equals to 4, k equals to 2. So n has 2 prime factors, right? 2 and 2. So we get at least 2 factors of n, which means there should be a with this nk combination. So what would be that a? So the one a that could be possible is 2 into 3. Why? So if you look at this a, the total number of factors should be 2 to the power, here the power is 1, so we'll take power 1 and add 1, which is 2. Here power is 1, so we add 1, here then it becomes 2. So we'll multiply 2 into 2 to get 4, and you can see that in this A we have total 4 factors, and out of which the 2 are primes. And what would be that prime factors? So that would be 2 and 3, right? So now let me show you my code, and code is pretty straightforward. So what I'll do is that we have n and k. So what I'll do is that I'll find all the prime factors of n, and it will return the number of prime factors of n. And if this number is greater than k, in that case we say that yes, there could be multiple a, so we'll print 1, else we'll print 0. So what I'll do in the prime factor function is that I'll find all the factors of n and add that into a vector, and at the end I just return the size of this vector, right? So in this sample test case we get 1, right? So that's it for this video. If you like our content, make sure to subscribe this channel, and don't forget to like this video. Thank you. Have a nice day.